Hello, I'm Carly McAvoy. Today I'm talking about equations and overview. We've already talked about equations on a different levels, but this is kind of an overview of the whole thing. When you're faced with solving an equation, there's a certain process, and that is first, get rid of parentheses by using the distributive property. Secondly, simplify both sides of the equations by combining like terms. We're going to do some examples of all of these things. Move variable terms and constant terms to opposite sides of the equation by using the addition property of equality. Remember, sometimes you have to use the addition property of equality twice. Make the coefficient equal positive 1 by using the multiplication property of equality. In this case, you're only going to use the multiplication property of equality once. I was trying to write multiplication. I don't know what was happening here, but anyways. Nobody's perfect. You don't have to be perfect to be good at math. Check your answer by substitution. So there's those steps we're going to follow as we come into these equations. The first two equations I have here don't have any parentheses, so I don't need to worry about getting rid of parentheses. But I do need to do step two, which is simplify both sides of the equation by combining like terms. Over here I do anyway. This one, no, I don't even have that, right? Nope, don't have any. I don't need to simplify because there's no like terms on either sides of these equations. So moving on to number three, I want to move the variable terms and the constant terms to opposite sides. That's where I'm at for this equation. I have constant terms. I want to put my variable terms on the left and my constant terms on the right. So if I get rid of 54b by subtracting it from both sides, 57 minus 54 is now 3b. I still have the 140. Over here, these two things are gone, right? 54b minus 54b is gone, and I have negative 100. Okay, now I still want to get the variable term by itself. So now here's where I'm going to use this the second time. This is where the twice comes in, because now I'm going to move 140 to the other side and get my 3b alone. Negative 100, negative 140 is negative 240. And when I divide both sides now, the next step, make the coefficient 1. Right now my coefficient is 3, so I'm going to get rid of that by dividing it by itself. And then I get b, I don't write the 1, but that's 1b, negative 240 divided by 3 is negative 80. Perfect. I can check that by substitution. 57 times negative 80 plus 140, I hope I don't run out of space here, should equal 54 times negative 80 minus 100. Yeah, I should have left more space for that, right? But anyways, let's do that. 57 times negative 80 is negative 4,560. And 54 times negative 80 is negative 4,320, and negative 4,320 minus 100 is negative 4,420. On the other side, negative 4,560 plus 140 is negative 4,420 on the left side. So that checks out. And negative 80 is my correct answer, because when I substituted in, I got the same answer on both sides. Okay, let's look at number two. Well, number two, the problem here is that I need to simplify both sides. So I am at that second step, simplify both sides of the equation, because I have x's on both sides, and I have numbers on over here, and I have two x's on one side, whatever. So I'm not doing the opposite like I did when I wanted to move them across the equal sign. When I'm on the same side, I just combine them up. 19 minus 7 is 12. And over here, I have 6x. 31 minus 15 is 16. Now, does it matter if I put the 16 first or the 6x? No, it doesn't matter. I could have put 16 plus 6x. So now I want to move my terms to opposite sides. That's step number three. I'm going to subtract 6x from both sides, and that's going to leave 6x minus 2. These 6x's are additive inverses. They go away. and I have positive 16, I don't need that plus sign. And then I want to get rid of this negative 2. So I'm going to add 2 to both sides, and that gives me 6x equals 18. The coefficient here is 6, and so I'm going to divide both sides by 6 and get x equals 3. Do I have enough room to plug into this? Well, let's do this. Let me help myself out here. We'll just save ourselves a little space. I'm going to say, what is 19 times 3? That's 57. So I have 57 minus 2 minus 7 times 3, which is 21, should equal 31 plus 6 times 3 is 18 minus 15. So I just didn't write down 19 times 3, but that's where I got those numbers. So I have 57 minus 2 minus 21 is 34. And on the other side, I have 31 minus 18 plus, that's not what I have, right? I have plus 18 and minus 15. And that's 34 as well. So I can always substitute to check. Okay, so in the first one, we use steps 3, 4, and 5. And in the second one, we use steps 2, 3, 4, and 5. And now we're going to look at some that require the parentheses, which is getting rid of the parentheses by distributing. When I distribute, I multiply the number on the outside of the parentheses times everything inside. I have to be aware of the signs when I do that. 3 times x is 3x, and 3 times negative 1, or minus 1, is minus 3. 1 times 3 is 3, and then minus 12 equals 0. Continuing on, I'm on step 2, simplify both sides. Well, there's nothing to simplify over here. Negative 3 and negative 12 is negative 15. And now I want to move variable terms to one side and constant terms to the other. Now in this problem, if I add 15 to both sides, I get 3x equals 15. I didn't use this twice. Remember, we used it twice before. But we don't need to always use it twice. Sometimes yes, sometimes no. This one time separated our variables and our constant terms, so that was it. Getting rid of the coefficient by dividing by the coefficient, and that gives you x equals 5. And I can check that. I can say 3 times 5 minus 1 minus 12 should be 0. That's 3 times 4. 3 times 4 is 12, and 12 minus 12 equals 0. That's the check. That's the check. But this is the solution. When we solve an equation, we're asking, what does that variable equal? Okay, let's look at number 4. Number 4 has everything in it, all of our steps, so it's a good one to look at. We're going to multiply the 3 times the 5c, that's 15c, and 3 times 1 is 3. I have a plus there, so that's going to stay a plus. Minus 12 is 13c plus 3. So we got rid of parentheses. Step 2, simplify. Nothing to simplify over here, but over here we can add the plus 3 and the minus 12 together. That gives us 15c minus 9. You can do those calculations on your calculator. It'd be great if you could do them in your head, but you know, you don't have to be able to do all that in your head to be proficient at math. And then we're going to move things using step number 3. We're going to use it twice, once to move the c's and the other to move the constant terms. So the c terms, or the variable terms here, 15 minus 13 is 2c, and over here these go away and you get 3. Then I'm going to get that constant term out of there because I want c to be alone, and I get 2c equals 12. And finally, I want that constant term to have a coefficient, or that variable term to have a coefficient of 1, and I divide by 2, then I get c equals 6. There's my answer, and we know we can substitute back in to check that. What would 5 times 6, that's 30, plus 1, that's 31. Let's save ourselves a little trouble and just say that would be 31 minus 12. And then 13 times 6, what's 13 times 6? You probably have that in your head before me, 78. plus 3. And now 3 times 31 I know is 93. And then 78 plus 1 is 81. 93 minus 12 is also 81. There's my check. It doesn't take that long to check, and then you're confident and you can move on. Okay, two more and then we'll be done. Why did I do this one? Let's see. There's always a reason why I put certain ones in there. Number 5, add 8y to both sides. Should have used the other color. If I add 8y to both sides, I get negative 9 and positive 8. I get negative y or negative 1y. That throws people off sometimes because they don't know what to do with it, but you do just like you would normally. Next, we're going to get rid of the constant term over here. And then we're going to get negative 5. And then we would say divide both sides by negative 1. We need our coefficient to be positive 1, so we just divide by the negative by the negative, and that gives us y equals 2 negatives make that positive 5. Okay? And I can always check that negative 9 times positive 5 is negative 45. Negative 8 times positive 5 is negative 40. Negative 45 plus 1 is negative 44. Negative 40 minus 4 is also negative 44, and that checks out. The reason I put that one in there is because that negative is tricky for people. The reason I put this one in here is because this minus sign in front of a set of parentheses throws people off. This 4 has nothing to do with that distribution. What I'm distributing here is a negative 1. You can think of it as that. We don't see the 1, but it's like it's there. We can always put a 1 in front of something, under something, wherever we want it, as long as we're multiplying or dividing by it. So now we're going to distribute negative 1 times p. That's a negative p. And negative 1 times 9, that's a negative 9. It essentially changes the sign of everything inside the parentheses. It doesn't change the number because you're multiplying by 1, but it can change the sign. So 5 times 2 is 10p. That's multiplying those. And 5 times 1 is 5, but we have a minus 5 there. So we got rid of the parentheses. Now we're going to combine like terms on both sides. There's nothing to combine over here. They're not like terms. I can't do anything. But over here, I can say 4 minus 9. Have 4 take 9 away. I've got negative 5 minus p. And now I'm going to get that, use the addition property of equality twice. First, I'm going to move the 10p by subtracting it. So I have negative 5 minus 11p is equal to negative 5. And then I'm going to add 5 to both sides. Oh yeah, there's another reason I did this problem. That's right. Negative 11p now equals 0. Now, sometimes when people see that, they kind of freak out and say, wow, there can be no solution. But there definitely is a solution. And the solution is, when I divide both sides by the coefficient, put it in your calculator. 0 divided by anything is always going to be 0. So the answer is p equals 0. It's okay to have 0 as an answer. It happens. So what would I have if I plugged this in? If p was 0, I would have 4 minus 0 plus 9 is just 9. And over here, I'd have 5 times 2 times 0 is 0. So I'd have minus 1. 4 minus 9 is negative 5. And 5 times negative 1 is negative 5. And it checks out. All right, keep practicing equations. There's always good equations.